right leg do its function, the left leg. The right hand, the left hand. The right ear, the left ear. When I was reading about John, he was shown the vision of heaven. And then he went there, the window opened. He saw the 24 elders surrounding him. He said, then he saw the four heads of people. One, the second one, I think that one was a human being. Then what surprised John was that their heads were full of ice. Which means those beings, they don't have to turn the way I'm turning to see who is behind me. Oh, they have eyes around.
Yes.
That's the Bible says. My friends, Jesus is here.
Amen.
I can feel his presence. I can feel the presence of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And I was praying, God, give me the message. I never prepared. When he told me, I never prepared. I said, those are God's people. I'm going the way you want, and let me say whatever you want me to say. So today you are come here. You are going to write a covenant for your children, for the next four generations.
Oh, yes.
A generation merely is about 70 years. So if you make the covenant correct today, if you make the covenant correct today, you now have 280 years that your family is going to enjoy.
Amen.
My friends, don't miss this chance.
Amen. Lord.
Hallelujah.
Wow.
So we bless first generation, second generation, third generation. If we can merely put at around 70 years as a generation, know that today, anyone who is here, you are making a covenant, just like David met. You are making a covenant that's going to stay in your family for 280 years.
Amen.
70 times 4.
Glory to God.
So those are coming from Kericho, coming from Nakra. If you can utilize this space, that's what I'm giving you some space to start thinking what you want to do so that you can please God. So that when God looks at you, even if you have come from Mombasa or Kericho or elsewhere or the village, God will be looking at you and say, yes, I will protect you, I will lead you when you wear the valleys and the hills. Wherever you go, I will be with you and protect. And I see a dread in that head, in the Numbers chapter 6, and that God will give you protection. When God blesses you, the first thing he does is protect you. The second thing God does when he blesses you, he makes sure you don't lack. So he will always provide. He will always sponsor you. And the third thing, God will give you peace. So even if you are posted to Bokot or to Elton, you just say, God, I'm waiting. Because he will protect you, he will sponsor you, he will also give you peace. How many of our ladies, she might have 50 clothes, but she's still telling her husband, I saw another dress when I went to, when I was shopping, so I said, can you do something? And another woman has only three. But some of us have ladies about when we just grew up a I was to me, na bado akienda kiona ingine, mwenzake akiwa nao anatamani. Hayana amani ndani mwake. When God gives you peace, it doesn't matter whether your neighbor has a story house, has a good vehicle, he gives you peace and he walks with you, and wherever you go, you are at peace.
Amen.
You have peace with yourself. You are okay.
Hallelujah.
You are at peace. My friends, that the peace that we are going to pray, that may God protect the police officers here and all of us. And he cannot protect, the Bible says, after Misha Kubariki. At Kubariki, Sasa, now, where will you talk about it? Now, do you know, the Bible tells us, say, that's my way. Much as some people are not good, they don't want the police officers. There are some police officers.